China economy is ready to disintegrate. Companies are leaving China and Chinese migrants are returning home to the mainland. China will soon become isolated and poor once again. The impact of the Wuhan virus pandemic is coming down heavily on the world, and the Chinese will be forced to pay the ultimate price for the willful destruction of the world. In latest development, foreign companies are fleeing the borders of China due to uncertainties around the post-COVID world, thereby leaving Chinese native of the country jobless. Elsewhere, countries are tightening their foreign direct investment rules to block any hostile Chinese takeovers in sensitive sectors that are of national security interest. While all of this is happening, in mainland China, Chinese people are being denied work in companies abroad as the locals have started objecting to their recruitment. They say when it rains, it pours, and Beijing's problems are really getting compounded with each passing day, and sadly for the Xi Jinping regime, this is just the tip of the iceberg. Make no mistake about it, China will never be the same once this pandemic is over. If you find this video to be informative, consider to give the channel a subscribe. I want to hear from you, please comment and share. Several reports have stated that companies that have seen disruption in their supply chains and the manufacturing business in the wake of coronavirus have made up their minds to dump China. It started with Japan earmarking US$2.2 billion out of its US$993 billion economic stimulus package to help its manufacturers shift production out of China. Japan taking the business away from Beijing was the watershed moment, and other countries started following the suit soon. South Korean heavyweights like Hyundai Steel, Lotte, Kia, and several other companies too are considering relocating their manufacturing facilities from China to India. We have requests from two iron and steel companies, some startups, and one from the hospitality sector which wants to come to India from China, said a Korean consulate official in Chennai. To further aggravate Beijing's misery, a government intelligence officer has informed that about 1,000 companies are currently engaged in discussion at various levels, such as investment promotion cell with central government departments and state governments, to move their work to India. Covered by TFI, Apple is considering moving about 20% of its iPhone production capacity to India because of the massive supply chain disruption that has broken the back of the manufacturing ecosystem of China. Apple in China, directly and indirectly, employs about 480,000 people, and if it moves out of mainland China, a large portion of the workforce will be rendered jobless. Rising job losses and persistent xenophobia over the origins of the coronavirus are leading to growing resentment against Chinese migrant workers in Indonesia. Legislators in southwest Sulawesi province rejected the planned arrival of about 500 workers hired by the Chinese-backed PT Virchadragon Nickel Industry and PT Obsidian Stainless Steel despite permits being issued by the central government in Jakarta. The provincial governor Ali Meza told state news agency Anthara he supported the call, adding that society is not ready to welcome foreign workers. Italy, one of the worst-hit countries, has a significant Chinese expatriate population. Northern Italy is home to more than 50% of Italy's Chinese population, and most work in the textile factories. When coronavirus struck the region, the companies were shut down. As a result, the Chinese were rendered jobless. Constant jeering and xenophobia from the locals and job losses prompted the Chinese populace in Tuscany to return to China. These are some of the many examples where the innocent Chinese are paying the price for its communist masters sitting in Beijing. China let the coronavirus snowball into a pandemic. The pandemic would have never assumed the monstrous shape that it has taken, had it not been for the opaque communist regime that detained and mysteriously disappeared whistleblowers, doctors, and journalists who spoke about COVID-19. While the pandemic is ongoing and its people are reeling from its effect, the Xi Jinping has upped its predatory company takeovers in foreign countries. The Chinese companies, private as well as public, are looking to pump up investments in companies all around the globe to use as leverage in the post-COVID world. Sensing an imminent dragon threat, the European Union nations like Italy, Spain, Germany, and now India and the US have tightened their foreign direct investment rules. With a bleak future and a threat of financial sanctions and reparations, the companies are sensing it is the right time to jump the sinking ship of China and find a more suitable and conducive environment like India. An exodus of companies from China is waiting to happen. As a result, millions will be rendered jobless. Thanks for watching.